Let me sign in with Instagram as well. We are on our 2 o'clock broadcast. I pray that I once okay, I did good. That I did that right for Instagram. How's everyone doing? This is our 2 o'clock broadcast for the beauty industry, right? Where I bring the business. For those of you who have never been in a live broadcast with me before, first of all, shame on you. Second of all, I am Tanya Wilson Cherry. I'm a business consultant and certified life coach. Thank you for all of those beautiful hearts on Periscope. I appreciate it. I'm a business consultant and certified life coach. I have a 20 plus year background as a licensed cosmetologist in the beauty industry and 10 years as a former salon owner. I help entrepreneurs and beauty industry professionals like yourself. Hey, darling, how are you, dear? Like yourself, form working systems in their business, right? That help them to retain the customers that they have, help them to get new customers and profit, help you save time and money, all of that, right? While creating a lifestyle that you really love. Hey there on Instagram, how are you? And so, hey there, who's that hair company? Hey there, how's it going? And so my normal scheduled broadcasts are Mondays and Wednesdays at 8:30 a.m. I come on and give you guys some inspiration, right? Some mindset stuff, because if you followed me long enough, you know I believe that your mind has a lot to do with your money. This thing right here. Your thinking has a lot to do with your money and everything else that you set out to do. So we talk about mindset things, and I share some things that will inspire you to greatness, right? Because there's a leader in all of you. And so I come on at 8:30 to inspire you to do that on Mondays and Wednesdays. And at 2 o'clock each week, I come on to bring the business for the salon industry. Before we get started, our title is 8 tips and strategies hairstylists and salon owners can use to benefit from social media. 8 tips and strategies salon owners and hairstylists can use to benefit from social media. And so before we get into that, I want to take care of some house business, and I want to make sure that you guys have a fair opportunity to take advantage of the flash sale that I have for an amazing program that I've created. I began creating the program last year and developing it for hairstylists and salon owners only, based on what you guys need, based on what you've said you struggle with the most. And one of the main things that I was con that people connected with me for was mentorship. I had so many people, guys, for the last maybe 3 to 5 years, asking me to be a mentor for them in the salon industry. And I realized that mentorship is huge. It's huge. It's a big connection, and there's a lot of time invested for the mentor and the mentee. And so in trying to figure out how can I mentor so many people at one time, so I developed what I call a boot camp, a mentorship and branding boot camp for hairstylists and salon owners only. And it's an 8-week boot camp. I myself am the instructor for the course, but I also have other experts joining me. Hey there on Instagram. Put your name in the comments. Tell me where you're from. I'm kind of getting used to the following on Instagram. And so I said, how can I, mentor all of these people that are connecting with me? So I'll be the instructor for that particular program, and then I'll have other experts to come on and join me. And we're going to talk about 3D stands for destiny, dollars, and discipline. Destiny, dollars, and discipline. And what mentorship is, and I don't know if people really understand what mentorship is. Mentorship is personal development, right? In a business environment. Personal development in a business environment. Because as you develop personally as a leader of your career as a hairstylist or your salon, your business will flourish. As you develop personally, your business will grow too. And so I use my years of experience. My mentor is also going to be helping to facilitate one segment of the course, and that's going to be amazing, guys. She has over 40 years in the industry. She's worked with Floyd Kenyatta. She's trained in Rome. She's trained stylists in Jamaica on several product lines. franchised out salons. She's owned about 20 salons, so she has a wealth of information that she's going to help impart into the 3D Success Bootcamp. So I'm excited about it, guys. We also have a young lady by the name of Kai Smith. You guys can catch her on Facebook. She's actually a trichologist. She'll come on and help you guys up level who you are as an actual hairstylist, right? So not only are we going to talk about personal development, but you guys will leave with an up level on your skill set as well, right? You love Kai, awesome. So she's going to be joining us in our boot camp as well for a look and learn. Yes, Kai Smith, yes. And my mentor is Carolyn Marshall Covington. She'll be joining us as well. I'm thinking about adding two guest experts, right, to the program, but it's power packed. It's pretty packed, guys. But I want you guys to get as much value from the boot camp as possible. We're going to talk about destiny, dollars, and discipline, right? Because destiny is kind of like getting clear, like what is my role in the industry? I know I went to school and got my hair license, but what role should I really play in the industry? One of the things I found out is that the industry offered so many opportunities for me to do so many different things other than just behind the chair. So we're going to address several of those opportunities that are available for you guys. You'll have an opportunity to get clear, right? To get a clear vision on where it is you want to head. So when it's time to take classes and courses and invest in your business, you'll know what to invest in. You guys get that? Because oftentimes we take classes or we do things and then we never do anything with them because they really don't have anything to do with the part of the industry that we're passionate about. So we're going to get clear on that. There's a section on discovery, right? And that's when you discover who you are, right? Because that's part of branding, guys. Part of branding is discovering who you are because you are your brand, whether you know it or not. So we will talk about branding in the aspect of who you are and who you'll be out in the world, how you'll position yourself in the beauty industry so that you can make some good money, right? And then we'll talk about marketing, that one thing that's usually missing from most hairstylists because we don't learn it in beauty school. We just don't learn how to market our services in beauty school. And then we're going to talk about dollars because you got to know about money, right, in order to do business. You got to have money to do business, and you have to know about money. There's a budgeting section in there. It's just so much. It's power packed. But the course is $497 for 8 weeks, and I offered a flash early bird sale that ends today in about 2 hours. It ends at 4 o'clock, and it's $137, guys. You can't beat it. So if you have an opportunity to take advantage of that, do it, right? Even if you know already that you're going to sign up now so that you can save and take advantage. It's almost a 70% discount. The link to that is bit.ly/3dsuccess1. So I wanted to go ahead and mention that early and take care of the house business so that you guys who are anticipating joining will have a chance to go to that link. I have it broken down into weekly sections, what it will be about. It is a virtual course, so it's from the comfort of your home. There will be replays, but it's so much better if you're actually in class so that you can get the work done. And the last week, we were going to have a planning session, right? Because there's no need to hear all of that information, and then you can't figure out how you're going to implement it into your daily life and your business. So you're going to leave the class with a 12-month action plan, right? So for those of you who maybe you've been in the industry for quite some time and you know reinvention is what you need, right? I need reinvention. I need to reinvent who I am in the industry. Or if you just started out in the industry and you know you need guidance from experts who've been doing it for a long time, who've already gone the mile, or if you're just at a place in the industry where you know you want to go to your next level, this course is for you. So go and check that out, guys. 3D Success branding, mentorship and branding bootcamp for hairstylists and salon owners, right? Because we want to make money. This is a billion-dollar industry. And so we want to make sure that we've positioned ourselves to be able to make as much as we possibly can, right? Where it's not hit and miss, where we don't feel like we're tied to the chair. Like, if I don't go to work, I'm not making any money and I'm just done, right? You want to make sure that you're doing enough in your business so that you can reap those benefits. Sister to sister, how are you, dear? So that you can reap those benefits, even if you have to be out of work, right? And the things that you're doing daily are going to constitute, hey, darling, whether or not you're comfortable when you need to be out with the kids sick or when you want to take a vacation. Guys, for years, I worked every single Saturday until I had an aha moment. I probably had only been off about maybe 7 Saturdays in 15 years. And I've been doing this about 24 years, but around that 15th year, and I don't want you guys to wait that late. I say, wait a minute. You know, I don't do, Saturdays are always dedicated to the salon. And so one of the things I had to do was to take a look at my finances. Awesome, awesome, awesome. And so I'm going to do a budgeting section in the course too, because you know, we don't want to just make money and then we can't figure out where it's at. Like, where's the money? In order for me to get some more money, I got to go back to work. So we do all of that. It's a power-packed course for your full circle career and your life as a professional in the beauty industry. And that link again is bit.ly/3dsuccess1. And the flash sale ends in 2 hours. You want to take advantage of it. So today's message, if you guys saw in the broadcast, I said 8 tips and strategies hairstylists and salon owners can use to benefit from social media. If you guys want to benefit from your time on social media, put a 1 in the comments for me. You know, I know no one wants to just be on social media just to be up here. Most of you who are business owners, salon owners, and hairstylists, you want to make good use of the time that you're up here, right? You don't want to feel like I'm just clicking like and commenting and I'm not really benefiting or profiting from my time on social media. So I'm going to share with you guys, if that's you, if you know that you want to be able to use social media so that you benefit from it too, right? Put a 1 in the comment. Absolutely, absolutely. No, I mean, you guys really don't have the time to just be finagling up here and you're not benefiting from it. So the first thing that you need to do, right, to benefit from social media is to be social, guys. I know that's so simple, but you guys have to be social on social media. And then you have to be intentional about being social on social media. And the reason why I say be intentional, because we are a tribe of stylists, you know, we kind of form cliques based on what we do. Most people do, most business professionals or people in the industry. And then it gets so far as if it's barbers, you know, they have a clique and then stylists have a clique. But guys, barbers and stylists are not our clients. Well, they're my clients because I'm a consultant for beauty industry professionals, but for the hairstylist and salon owner, those aren't your clients, right? So you want to be social intentionally with your target market, right? And people who are going to do business with you. It doesn't mean you can't socialize with anyone else because the networking is great, but you want to be intentional, guys. And so your messages on social media have to be targeted to the people who you want to service, right? The next thing, the next way, the next tip or strategy for social media so that you can benefit from it is to complete your profiles. Complete your profiles, guys. Your Facebook profile, your Twitter profile. If you have a YouTube channel, complete that. Instagram. And when I say complete it, I mean, what is it that you do? And okay, as a stylist, you may do weaves, cuts, color, braids, you name it, right? You don't necessarily have to list all of those things. You want to niche them down to a few things that you do, but the main thing in your bio needs to be how you can help the customer. Because at the end of the day, people don't really care as much about our titles as they care about what we can do for them, right? how we can help them. One of the titles that I have for one of my social media platforms, I don't remember which one it is, but it says, I help stylists profit in their business. Because if a stylist comes along and reads my bio, I could list all of these things that I've done. You know, I've been the commencement speaker for the graduating class of 2016. I've, taught for a seed grant program for the Chamber of Commerce. I could list all of that stuff. And at the end of the day, if I didn't put anything in there that lets the customer or potential customer know what I can do for them, they're more likely to kind of just move on. They may even click like, right, but just keep moving. So to really benefit from social media, complete your profiles, guys. Put a clickable link to your websites or maybe your appointment website. If you do appointments online, if it's StyleSeed or you use some other type of app, also put a clickable link in there so they can learn more about you. I think what we don't realize is there are so many organic customers on social media who scroll past our information every day. And if we don't have what's necessary in order to attract the customer, then they just keep scrolling. So complete your profiles, guys. The third thing, of course, posting pictures in our industry, or in you all's, I'm still a licensed stylist, posting pictures is important because, you know, people kind of want to get an idea of our work, but especially if you're on Facebook, because Facebook's algorithms and what that is the way they show posts, how long they show them, and who they show them to. Facebook's algorithms are set up so if you post pictures, it actually gets shown to more people. And the reasons the algorithms are set up that way is because people tend to look at pictures more. So Facebook takes that into consideration with how they show things. And guys, we can learn a lot from Facebook, right? Because they're serving whoever on Facebook the way they want to be served the best. What they've shown, they've studied the customer, which is what we got to do too, right? We have to study people to know what they want and to know what we have that we can offer them. And then we got to give it to them to the full, right? So you want to make sure that you're posting several pictures on social media, because especially on Facebook. And definitely we know Instagram because it's a picture site, right? It's a picture site. But you guys can also give them opportunities when you post your pictures to DM you. You can give them an opportunity to DM you, a direct message you if they have more information, because there's no way for a clickable link except in your bio. So always keep that clickable link in your bio. If they see a picture that they like from you, they can still go back to your bio and click on the clickable link. And for Instagram, you'll need a business account, right? So that you can put the clickable link in. You'll sign up for a business account. The next thing you want to do on social media, tips and strategies. You want to write posts that engage the customers. You want to write engaging posts, ask them questions, you know, give them an opportunity to respond back to you. That's engaging with the customers. It's being social. Some of you may do it automatically because you're just a social person, but actually those things that you're doing organically are the things that work. And so for those of you who incorporate those things, right? Be social on social media. So make sure that you make posts that are engaging to the consumers, not necessarily to stylists, unless that's who you're teaching. Unless your plan is to teach stylists, you wanna talk to the people who you want to do business with you. Your target market is who you should be focusing on, because that's your goal for gaining customers. So make sure you're speaking to them. Another thing that you can do on your business page on Facebook, you can offer, one, you can give customers an opportunity to receive a discount if they like your business page, right? You guys can give them an opportunity to receive a discount if they like your business page. This is engagement. This is a call to action where you benefit and the customer benefits as well. And one of the things that you can offer on your page, if you have, say, like a 20% off promotional, you may say something like, in order to receive this promotion, you must mention that you saw it on Facebook. And it will only be from Facebook that they can actually receive that 20%. It's not an in-house promotion or any other place that you market or advertise your services. But this way, you'll know how effective your efforts are on social media. You'll learn how effective your marketing is on social media. So guys, make sure that you do things like offer percentages off, encourage people to like your business page. Not to say that you're gonna only use your business page, because the algorithms on your business page are even lower than, or they're maneuvered totally different. Even from your Facebook page, because they ultimately want you to buy an ad on your business page. But when people go to look at your business page, they'll at least see some activity on the page. Because if they don't see activity on the page, if they don't see things recent, for instance, if it's March of 2016 since you posted the last thing on your business page, they may wonder if you're still in business, because they don't know, guys, right? They're looking at that as an extension to your business. So you want to post things, and you're not going to get as many likes on that page because of the algorithms, but you still want to have activity on your business page so that when new people come, there are opportunities for them to connect with you, and they see that you're still active, and they won't think you've closed down and gone out of business. So the next thing, number five, or is that six? That's number six, actually. Share posts related to what you do, right? If you have this, one of the things, I did a class called Video Content and Media Content, where I help people in the class to create a content map. And I think Periscope went out on me. Give me one second, guys. It did. One second. Thanks, guys, for your patience. I appreciate it. So one of the things that I did in the class, I'm going to keep moving forward and see if I can connect with them while I'm talking. One particular client in the class said that she struggled because what her clients asked her to do was not necessarily what she wanted to do all the time. And sometimes we can't make that decision where we say, well, I don't do that anymore, because we're building our clientele or because we got to pay the bills, right? And what I suggested to her was to market for the service that she wanted to do. It doesn't mean she's going to lose the customers that she already has, but if you're on social media, that's your opportunity to actually market for the service that you would like to begin doing, right? Because when people see your styles, regardless of what the style is, in their mind, they're thinking this is something that you do all the time or that you enjoy doing. Yeah, I see that Periscope went out on me. I'm going to just push two and start it all over again, see what it does. Okay, I'm back, Periscope. Sorry for the interruption. Eight tips and strategies hairstylists and salon owners can use to benefit from social media. Quick introduction in case this person that's coming on the replay or jumping in the broadcast did not see the first broadcast. I'm Tanya Wilson-Cherry. I'm a business consultant and certified life coach. I have a 20-plus year background as a licensed cosmetologist in the beauty industry and 10 years as a former salon owner. I help beauty industry professionals grow their clientele, keep the customers they have, and profit so that they can save time and money, right, and live the life that they truly desire. And we're talking about eight tips and strategies hairstylists and salon owners can use to benefit from social media. And we had a little interruption before, so I had to start you guys back over with no title, right? So eight tips and strategies hairstylists and salon owners can use to benefit from social media. And we are on number six, and that is to share posts that are related to what you do. And what I mean by that, guys, you guys may find a post with some information on it. One of the things I shared recently was about Madam CJ Walker, who was recorded, or many people thought she was actually the first millionaire, right? Thought she was the first millionaires to hit the scene. But in actuality, her mentor was Alice Malone. Her mentor was actually the first millionaire. So I posted those things on my social media website because they made their money inside the beauty industry, That's where they made those millions, guys. And because I talked to stylists and salon owners, I felt it was great information. It didn't have anything to do with me consulting, right? But it was still connected to the industry, and it was still great information that stylists would want to know. Another reason I intentionally posted that is because I wanted them to understand that we're in a billion-dollar industry. Hello, somebody. We're in a billion-dollar industry, and so we have to find creative ways to market ourselves and to do business so that we can get our portion, right? There are many stylists who are wondering, like, how am I going to make it from week to week? And one of the things that I realize is most successful stylists and salon owners, if you sit down and talk with them, they will tell you that they had a mentor. Am I right, sister to sister? They will tell you that there was one or two people that they looked up to, that they watched, that they learned from, that helped them in their career, that guided them and told them which direction to head in. And so that's one of the huge things that I think is missing in the industry. So in my attempts to share information related to what I do, I shared the information about Madam CJ Walker, who they used to say she invented the straightening comb, but actually her mentor invented the straightening comb, guys, and she just improved it. And so, guys, for those of you who weren't on with me for the other broadcast, that is one of the reasons I am doing the absolutely right, Ms. Rhonda. That's one of the reasons I am offering the 3D Success mentorship and branding bootcamp for hairstylists and salon owners, because I realize there are a lot of stylists that they just don't have a mentor. They kind of came in the industry, you know, began doing hair. Maybe they were good with, you know, a style that looked good, but as far as guidance in the industry, it's not there. They didn't have it. Guys, when I first started out in the industry, well, let me say my second round, because I actually moved from one city to the next and had to rebuild my clientele. And one of the things that I remember was sitting. Y'all don't hear me. One of the things I remember doing while waiting to build my clientele was sitting. And I find that that is not something that today's stylist wants to do. I mean, I didn't want to do it then either. But guys, I built a full clientele that I could depend on in 6 months. And some people have been in the industry for 5, 7, and 10 years, right, that have not felt comfortable about their clientele yet. People won't help them. I think there are people, Bernice, more blessings are coming from Sharon. Oh, thank you. I think this is what I realized too, because, you know, I really began to study mentorship, and I understand that mentorship is a relationship where the stylist or the mentee and the mentor benefit. And so when you look at most mentorship relationships from the past, it wasn't just this person that was given all of this information to someone who they didn't benefit from as well. And I think we kind of left part of mentorship out, because the person that was your mentor, also you worked with them, right? Or there was opportunities for you guys to work together. Now, of course, I think there are times where we just share things, right? This is one of the things that I do when I come on my broadcast, I share, right? Mentorship from afar. But I think people don't really understand that mentorship is a relationship where both people benefit and they're dedicated to it. And so I've had so many people ask me to mentor them, but I understand that I don't want to commit to something and then somebody fall off from it, right? I don't want to commit to something and then someone is like kind of half in. And when you're talking about things from online, an online or long distance perspective, you're not quite sure how that's going to work. So oftentimes when people have to make an investment as well, they'll stay committed, right, and connected to the mentorship relationship. And plus, this was really the only way I could even imagine beginning to mentor the amount of people that were asking me to mentor them. So that was number six, guys. And you know, we got off course, but not really, because I was talking about posting things on social media that are related to what you do. And then I gave you guys an example of one of the things I posted that had, you know, I didn't say, you know, I'm a consultant or anything of that nature, but it connected to the industry and it connected to my target market and people that I serve. Number seven, Instagram. I mean, if you're a stylist and you don't know this, Instagram is a huge, it's, oh yes, mentorship is definitely a sacrifice, Miss Rhonda. It really, really is. Instagram is a huge platform for stylists. So if you didn't know that, I'm here to tell you, Instagram is a huge platform for stylists. But still, there may be stylists who are posting on Instagram but are not receiving some of the benefits that come with it. And, you know, if you go back through the things that I listed and I run down them again, you know, is your profile complete, right? Are you being social? Are you connecting back with people on Instagram? Because we can't just, you know, post things and expect to build a connection. Because one of the things that people have to do, right, they have to know, like, and trust you. People have to know, like, and trust you to do business with you. They can click like, say that looks great on tons of things that you post on social media, but if they don't know, like, and trust you, they'll never take that next step to actually make the exchange that is done from your marketing efforts, and that's to do business with you, right? Because people have to know, like, and trust you. So some of your posting on social media should simply be to add value. It should simply be to add value, and that creates a connection where people begin to know, like, and trust you to the point where they want to make the exchange and actually do business with you. But Instagram is one of the major platforms for stylists. And one of the things you guys can do is connect your Instagram to your Facebook. And you can go into your settings on your Instagram app, and you'll see something that says link accounts. And that way you can connect the two. And whenever you post on Instagram, it will automatically go to one of your social media pages, and that way you're not posting all day, right? You're not leaving one platform to post here and another platform to post there. And I believe Facebook bought Instagram anyway, so of course they work together. If you guys get into promotions and running ads, you'll see that running an ad on Instagram is also an option when you run an ad on Facebook. But yes, connect your Instagram and your Facebook together, guys, so that you are killing two birds with one stone. And the next thing, this is something that you guys can do that will get your clients involved. It will cause movement on social media, and that's to do a selfie contest. How many of you have ever done a selfie contest in your salon? Because people are on social media, right? Our clients will send us a selfie picture every now and then, but how you can maximize that effort is to offer a selfie contest. And what you'll do is maybe you run the contest for 2 weeks, and whichever client gets the most likes on their post, you guys think of a hashtag that you're going to use, right? And it's probably going to be your salon name, or you know, whatever you go by as the brand, as a stylist or salon owner, but give them a hashtag, or it can be the name of the contest that you're using, selfie contest, and then whatever the name of your salon is, some type of hashtag that each client can use, so that you'll have a way to go back and check to see how many likes the selfie got. And then you give them some type of promotion for winning, right? And I would probably do something for everybody who participated, but I would do something extraordinary for the person who won. And what this does is, now you've taken all of your clients' friends will see the selfie, and all of their friends will see the selfie, and it just creates a domino effect, and you're increasing your visibility simply by doing something great for your clients who participated in the selfie contest on social media, right? On Facebook, or I think you can tag as well on Instagram. So that's another way, another strategy or tip that you guys can use to benefit from social media. Number one was be social, right? Number two, complete your profiles, guys. Make sure you have a clickable link in your profile if it's available. If you're a hairstylist, especially on Facebook, tell them you're a hairstylist. I have a private group on Facebook, and one of the requirements is that they're a licensed stylist. So one of the first things I do when people want to connect or join the group is I go back to their page to see if I, first of all, see anything about hair. And some people, I don't even see anything about hair or what it is that they do. And so oftentimes, if that's the case, they're losing the organic ability to reach clients, right? Because some of it is just organic, because you have it in your profile. You may have commented on someone's post. They may have clicked your name. Hey, who was that? And when they go back to your profile, if they see nothing, they don't know that you're a hairstylist, right? They don't know to connect with you for the very thing that you do to bring money and increase into your life and business. So complete your profiles. Three is post a lot of pictures, right? Visual is great for Facebook. It changes the algorithms. More people are engaged with pictures than just your normal posts. Doesn't mean you don't post, right? Doesn't mean you have to do 20 pictures a day, but you do want to be consistent and posting multiple pictures because those are the posts that get viewed more regularly. And then of course on Instagram, you know, you can't do nothing but post pictures, right? And Instagram is so great because you don't have to post nearly as much on Instagram to get connections and feedback. It's one of the easiest platforms, and I'm just beginning to use Instagram to that level, right? Because one, I knew I wasn't doing hair anymore, but I also realized that my ideal customer is on Instagram. And so Instagram is one of the easier ways to build a following, right? And build up your client list because of the algorithms. They're not as strict as Facebook's algorithms are. And so you don't have to do nearly as much posting to get people to follow you or like your posts or your pictures. So that's a little plug for Instagram. It's a great place for stylists. Number four, we said offer percentages off on your Facebook page and then let the consumer know the only way to receive this offer is if you mention that you saw it on Facebook. It's a great way to keep clients coming back to your page to see what's new, to see what you have to offer. And then it's also a way for you to check to see how your marketing efforts are working on social media, right? Because they have to mention that that's where they saw it from. And one of the things I find, especially with stylists, because, you know, marketing isn't something we learn in beauty school, but we do things and we don't know where the traffic came from. We don't have a way to measure whether or not our marketing efforts are working. So that's a great one. A great way to measure is to give them a call to action where they have to make sure they mention that they saw this ad at a specific place. And then you're able to say, okay, my marketing efforts on this platform are working. Number six, share posts related to what you do. Talk about what you do. Give them tips and information. Create some type of value for the customers because people have to know, like, and trust you. And they don't always want to feel like you're selling them something every single time you make a post. It doesn't have to be about selling, right? You want to create a connection with them and allow them to know, like, and trust you. So make sure that you're posting things that are related to what you do, though, right? Things that are related to what you do. And next is make sure that you connect your Facebook and Instagram so you're working smarter and not harder. Smarter and not harder. Connect them. Go to your Instagram section settings and hit link accounts and link those two accounts together so that when you're broadcasting, it goes not just to your Instagram page, but automatically to your Facebook as well. And then last but not least is try doing a selfie contest with your clients. It's going to create a buzz inside the salon as well as on your social media. You will be tagged on, if you have 5 to 6 clients who agree to do the selfie contest, now you're on all of their pages and people are clicking like on it all the time. So that's exposure, guys. Not only are you creating an opportunity to do something great for your customer, but you're also increasing your visibility as a hairstylist or a salon owner. So guys, those are my 8 tips and strategies, ways that you can benefit from social media. I'll leave you guys today reminding you that the flash sale for the 3D success, which is Destiny Dollars and Discipline Mentorship and Branding Bootcamp, the flash sale ends today, probably in about an hour and a half now, because we had 2 hours before when I first came on the broadcast. But the 8-week bootcamp is $497. You guys can get it for $137, but only for the next 2 hours. And then it goes up to the next option that I have for pay, okay? 3D success, Destiny Dollars and Decisions for hairstylists and salon owners. Maybe you've been in the industry for a while and you know reinvention is what you need and you don't quite know which area to turn because there are so many options for us as stylists in the beauty industry. There's so many other than just behind the chair. If you need vision and clarity, it's like, I just don't know which direction to head in the industry. And if I don't figure it out, I'm getting out of the industry. If that's you, you need to be in class. You need to be in class because you're going to be in with experts who will give you forward-thinking ideas, and sometimes you just need a new piece of information to shift your mindset to something greater, right? I believe there are so many opportunities within the beauty industry. One of the things my mentor talks about is reinvention. She's reinvented herself within the industry several times. I have as well, guys, from stylist to platform artist to educator to booth renter to salon owner and now to business consultant, right? And so there's so many different ways that you can reinvent yourself and still be within the same industry. So don't give up on the industry. You may just need a new piece of information. If you're a new stylist and you're like, look, I know I need a mentor. I need some type of mentorship and guidance so that I'm not making mistakes that are taking me 5 to 7 years to play catch up on, right? Then this mentorship bootcamp is for you. We're going to have several experts in the camp. The link to that is bit.ly/3dsuccess1. It's $4.97 for the 8-week bootcamp. And today, for about the next hour now, I think it's almost 4 o'clock is the ending time, you can get it for almost 70% off, right? $137. You can't beat it for 8 weeks. You can connect with us right from the comfort of your home. You can get the information that you need to take your business to the next level as a stylist in the industry. Thank you for those hearts on Instagram. I appreciate that. So guys, if you know you need the help, right? Maybe you're just in the industry and you know there's another level for you. Come, take the boot camp. Join us for 8 weeks of Power Pack. And this, I'm not just saying this, but this is an amazing class, if I do say so myself. And I've actually been planning it since last year. So many people connecting with me, wanting me to mentor them, and I needed to find a way where I could mentor several people at a time. In a setting where, you know, we could be one-on-one and they can ask me questions and I can really see if they're actively getting the work done for their next level. We're going to talk about leadership. We're going to talk about dollars, of course, because you need to know money in order to do business if you want to keep the doors open. Hello, somebody. So we're going to talk about budgeting, so many different things. And then we have look and learn sessions where experts are actually coming on and showing you a skill set and a technique. So you're going to have something to take back to the chair as well. It's Power Pack, guys. Don't miss it. I appreciate you guys as always. I will be back on for my normal scheduled broadcast on Wednesday. Got to get the grandbaby. Awesome, sister to sister. I'll be back on at Wednesday at 8:30 in the morning, and then 2 o'clock, I'll be on to bring the business. You all have an awesome day. Take those 8 tips and strategies. Go look and see if you filled out your profile properly. You know, go through the list. Catch the replay if you need to, just to do a checks and balances so that you can benefit and maximize your time and effort on social media. Peace.